Have you not known, and have you not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, neither faints nor is ever weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the weak, and to those who have no might, he gives his strength. Preserve me, O God, for in you I take refuge. The lions have fallen for me in pleasant places. Indeed, I have a beautiful inheritance. You make known to me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and at your right hand are pleasures forevermore. We join here together today as friends and family to celebrate the life and to honor the memory of Hermine Goldie. Mom. To Dion and Tremaine, to Dylan and Tristan, Sean and Maureen, Sasha, Brandon, Tyler, Troy and Desiree, Catherine and Andrew, and to my amazing wife Alison, my children Darren, Matthew and Kirsten, to Auntie Gwen, the rest of the Bradley family, and to Dad. You've all been constantly in our prayers and thoughts, and we thank you for sharing your mom, sister and aunt with all of us. As we come to honor the life of a mother, a grandmother, a sister, an aunt, and a dear friend, a life well lived, we need to remember that we come here today to celebrate Mom's life and to reflect on how she impacted each and every one of us. The very presence of so many of you here today is testimony to your sharing with us just how many lives Mom actually did touch. I know there are many, many others who would love to be here today who, for whatever reason, aren't here. And we know that their thoughts and prayers are with us. And to all those who have traveled and taken the time to be here, from the whole family, we thank you for your loving expression of sympathy, your support, but most of all, for your caring and your friendship. Can we bow our heads in an opening prayer? O Sovereign Lord and Heavenly Father, who holds all of life and time in his hands, we gather in this solemn place to remember the life and mourn the death of our loved one, Hermine. We ask that you would comfort each person here. May they be comforted by your word, encouraged through happy memories, and sustained by the hope of the resurrection for all who place their faith in you. Thanksgiving for years shared, for the love that was given and received by all those who knew Mom. Father, be to all of us today the God of all comfort and grace. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Would you all stand with me for the opening hymn, please?
Consider all the words I have said made.
Thank you, everyone. Indeed, how great God is. And the one overriding theme, apart from our love for Mom today, is that we acknowledge how great God is in our lives. From the readings earlier, I just want to raise a couple of points. And the first one is that he gives strength in our times of weakness. And today, I urge each and every one of you to turn to the Lord for the strength that you need and the comfort that he bestows on each of us. As we come to bid farewell today, we again realize the definiteness and the reality of death. It truly is a fact that we can never be fully prepared for the sadness, the emptiness, and the missing. But it's only when we are able to accept that death is part of life that the healing can begin. Would you gain strength from each other in remembering those happy times and unforgettable memories with Mom that left you forever changed? When we are weak, he gives us his strength. And I think anybody who's been around in the last couple of weeks will know just what incredible strength Mom displayed. And that wasn't only from herself. I do believe that the Lord infused her with strength, but not only Mom. Each and every one of us that was there, that have walked this road, have really received unbelievable and unnatural strength that we can look back and say, only the Lord could have got us through that, and only the Lord could have given us the strength and the might when sometimes it just seemed so incredibly impossible and so very, very difficult. But in our times of weakness, he fills us with his power and he gives us his strength. Secondly, the lions have fallen in good places. And you say, somebody who suffered like that, how could you say those lions have fallen in good places? Well, I believe that every day Mom lived was lions that fell in good places because we got to share that with her. We all come into this world from different walks of life. Some are born into rich homes, some into poor homes. We never quite know what the future holds. We may be happy or sad. We may be poor or rich, healthy or sick. We may have an ordinary life, or we may have a very extraordinary life. None of us really knows for sure. But life truly is what you make it. I know, without any shadow of a doubt, that Mom lived an extraordinary life. She was surrounded by the love and the support of her family and friends. And although not a stranger to struggles and the hardships of life, she overcame these, maintaining her naughty sense of humor, her incredibly quick wit, and her sharp mind, and in seeing the best and good in people and situations. Mom was the most generous person I knew. And she would do almost anything for anyone at any time. She gave of her very last, right to the very end. She was strong-willed, loyal, gentle, generous, wise, intelligent, practical, naughty, driven, determined, very stubborn, brave, and an extremely fair lady. But I think the most outstanding quality was that she was just real. There was no pretense with Mom. Even the road rage was real, and everyone who ever traveled with her will have learned some new words and new descriptions, and yes, of all the titles and the acclaim that one could bestow on Mom, first and foremost, she was all for family. Of course, her children and grandchildren were her pride and joy. She always provided a loving and safe home for her family and would never stand back allowing anyone to take advantage of them. This 74-year-old teenager was game for anything. Board games were her favorite. And of course, there were those all-nighters spent at Grand West or Caledon with Auntie Gwen. Mom and I had an instant connection. From the moment we met, we were so similar that when it came to buying Christmas and birthday presents for Alison and the kids, we had to go to the shop together, otherwise we would come back with exactly the same items. I guess sharing a home with her for over 20 years just proves how strong that connection was. I believe that Mom and I were soulmates. There were many times that she would be the first person I called to ask for advice or to think something through with, because we thought very much in the same way. She always supported my crazy ideas and encouraged me to try even when the chips were down and it looked impossible. When I worked at Precept and Mom was at WinPac, we both performed a very similar function. And there were always those calls to each other about how to do the SARS returns. And the frantic panic calls from me to her that would go, Mom, download the latest EasyFile version now before SARS changes it again. Sometimes I would phone her and I'd say, my submissions are done. And then mostly all I got was, oh bugger. My dogs and cats drove Mom to absolute distraction. She'd come out the room in the morning, and my office was right there next to her room, and I'd say, Mom, how are you today? And she'd go, oh, Andy, I'm not so well today. And then she'd see the cat on the counter, and she'd go, get off the counter! Okay, all is not lost yet. But you know what? There was never a Christmas that each and every one of those animals didn't get a present from her. That was Mom. She wasn't perfect, and she wasn't an angel. A lady with faults, like all of us, but from whom we can learn so much. Mom learned to love life and to make the most of it. She was indeed a richly charactered individual, and of whom we can truly say, She was simply the best. The lines fell in good places for all of us who knew her. And we have a beautiful inheritance. An inheritance, yes. You, every one of us, that new mom, have this beautiful inheritance. Her legacy that she left behind. She didn't leave behind physical possessions. What she left was much more valuable. She left a piece of herself in each and every one of us as a gift to the world. E.E. Cummings wrote these words, "I carry your heart, I carry it in my heart. I'm never without it. Anywhere I go, you go. And whatever is done by only me is your doing too. Here is the secret that nobody knows. The root of the root and the bud of the bud, the sky of the sky of a tree called life, which grows higher than any soul can hope or mind can hide. I carry your heart. I carry it in my heart." A beautiful inheritance for each of us to carry on. And Mom has seen the path of life. The old proverb says, there's a time to laugh and a time to cry, a time to plant and a time to reap, a time to be born and a time to die. And it's important that each of us take this time that is allotted to us, that we grieve correctly and fully, although we will never truly come to terms with our loss. Practically, Mom closed many doors in her life, and now she has closed that last door here on earth as she went to join all those who welcomed her into eternity. Because of Mom's faith in the Lord Jesus as her personal Savior, I have no doubt that instantly on Tuesday evening, she found herself in the presence of the Lord and heard the words, "Well done, good and faithful servant. Enter now into your rest. Come and see the place that I have prepared for you." And so for each of us who remain, tomorrow comes. And as much as today is a memorial for Hermine, tomorrow is for you. How are you going to pass on the legacy that Mom has left behind? Will you pass it on? Will you carry your heart, her heart, in your heart for the rest of your days? Today is still a day that's worth celebrating. For a life well lived, a race well run, a fight well fought, a prize well received, and a rest very well deserved. I want to close with these thoughts before I hand over to some of the family who have some memories to share. And Paul writes to the Philippians and he says, "Finally, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about these things." And that's my encouragement to you today. Would you remember these things about Mom? And as often as you think of her, think of these characteristics that so aptly fit her life as we knew her. I don't know who's going to be brave enough to be first. Troy, Alison, you can
fight it out
between you.
It might be better if I take my glasses off. Then you're all in soft focus. So then I won't see all the tears, and maybe I won't cry. So let's see. Good morning, and thank you for being here to celebrate Mom's life, and also obviously to reflect on your part or your role within that life. It truly is a difficult prospect to stand in your presence today, to speak of her with her not being here. I can tell you this, it is a blessing. It's a blessing that she's not here. the pain, the suffering. It was too much to bear, to watch. I can only imagine what she went through. But I can tell you, I have nothing but respect for Mom and her brave and courageous fight. She fought to stay with us all. She didn't give up. It was a sad end to her unique life and the amazing story that she wrote, and I think Andy's already mentioned that. And I was thinking about that story, and as with any child of a parent, your part in that story only starts well into that person's life, and that's true of me as well. So I don't know much about the early years of Mom's life, except for what she's told me or what others have mentioned. But it's funny, because suddenly I wish I'd listened more. And that I'd asked more questions. I believe her story was comprised at times of indescribable happiness and joy.
Thanks.
Those were the times that she cherished. She spoke of those times often. But she also endured the desperation of unhappiness and the bitterness of disappointment. Like all of us, my mom's story was controlled by her, but only up to a point. Often it was circumstances that dictated the direction in which her story would take. Circumstances that would be positive or negative in her life. I was very close to Mom growing up, and I was often called a mommy's boy. In fact, one of my earliest and happiest memories was going to the shop with my mom somewhere in Claremont on a roof, I remember that, and she went to go buy a record, a 78 single, if my memory serves. If you don't know what a 78 is, Google it. But not now, Matthew. Later. The record was by a young German boy called Heinke. And the song's name was I'm Your Little Boy. For years, I believed that that song was written and meant only for me and my mom. Why wouldn't I believe that? Because after all, I was the cutest of the brothers. I still am. Sorry, guys. That truth hurts. I played this song for her in the last 2 weeks as she lay in pain. She wasn't communicating anymore. But as I played the song, her eyes welled with tears. Her eyes welled with tears, and I was very aware of the fact that she was with us and she knew that we were there. And now I've lost my spot. Where's my spot? Come on. I can still say today, and I will always say, Mom, I'm your little boy. Unfortunately for me, my reign as the cutest came to an end when Alison arrived. And when she was born, I believe, Mom's best friend was born. And again, it would be circumstances that would lead Alison and Mom to have the most incredible life together. My mom spoke of her childhood filled with love from her mom, a special relationship that was cut short when her mom passed away from cancer at the young age of 54. I can only think, and I can only be certain of one thing, that I think my mom and Alison had a very similar and wonderful relationship. We as the boys also had a fantastic relationship with her, but it was different. Mom loved us equally, and I think we all had our own unique relationship with her. During the long week leading to Mom's passing, Dion arrived from his home on the West Coast, and he hadn't seen her for a few days. And when he saw her, his reaction was just a huge testament to his love and the way he broke down that day and held her. I'll never forget it. Dion took it hard, and he's taking it hard. Sean was amazing. Together with Maureen, they helped Mom so much, and for that we're very grateful. Sean has put on a brave face, but I know that he's hurting. Also on a very deep level. I love my mom so much, and I know she knew that. I will miss her, and I'll always have her in my heart. My only wish is that I hope she did not die disappointed in me. It was never my intention to disappoint her. I've cried more than I've ever cried before, but I'm so happy she's at rest. Sorry if I'm going on. As I mentioned, Alison was an amazing daughter to Mom and a friend, and I think their bond was incredible. Alison, you will never know how I respect and thank you for what you did for her. You were there for her through the whole journey. You brought her hope. You gave her courage to fight. And you, I believe, were the reason she wanted to live. Mom spoke often to me about her treatments and how she would just gladly give it up, just stop the treatments. And then she would look at me and she would say, but I can't do that to Alison. Alison, you held her hand and you lived up to every promise. Each and every one of the promises you made. When only you were with her, Mom chose to leave us when only you were with her. And I believe that is very significant. Andy, thanks for your contribution and all that you have done. Darren, Matthew, and Kirsten, you guys had the privilege of having Nanny with you virtually all of your life. And as difficult as this is, just remember that she loved you and enjoyed getting to know you more than she could her other grandchildren. A very privileged position. So thanks for what you did for her. The other grandchildren, Catherine, Sasha, Tyler, Brandon. Leave anybody else out? No, I'm coming to Andrew. Those that are here. Nanny loved you guys extremely, extremely. And I know that she would want you to know that you were just as important to her than anyone else. And then, of course, Dylan and Tristan, who can't be here today, and Andrew. They would all love to have been here, I'm sure. But we speak on their behalf and we just say thank you and acknowledge them. Guys, Nanny loved you very much as well. As I said at the beginning, and it doesn't sound like this, I'm doing very well, but today is a celebration of Mom's life. And we can say thanks for the 74 years that we had, that she had with us. And we all had a part to play in her life, be it a small part or a big part. And the fact that you are here today is testament to your love and your support for her and your support for us as Mom's family. I can only say thank you for that. I know that there have been many people that have prayed for Mom during her illness, and those that contributed in small or big ways. I'd like to say thank you to you all. I'd also like to say a special thanks to the Bradley family for all you guys did, from Mark in the US, right the way down to Stephen here, and I know Peter and David and everybody else did wonderful things, and I thank you, and Auntie Gwen, thank you very much. Stephen, thank you for coming out to the house as often as you did with Karen. Karen, your positive energy, hell man. Yes, you're the Duracell bunny or something. I tell you, there wasn't a smile on anybody's face and Karen would start and it would be like just a party going on in that room. But thanks for your wonderful spirit. You helped us through what was a very torturous time. I'm very, 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 very disappointed that I missed out on that best hot chocolate in the world. So you owe me one of those. I would like to thank Charmaine, Andy, and Maureen for the support that you've given and are giving to Dion, Alison, and Sean. And I would like to say thanks to Des, my wife, for her support to me. This difficult time could never, ever have been breached had it not been for her. I love you and thanks. I would also like to quickly thank Ilana and Julian for their kindness and all the help that you gave both to my mom, to Alison and her family, and to me. It means the world to me. And the words you've been looking forward to in closing. Mom loved to gamble. She loved to spend many hours at Grand West. And it was always fun to go there with her. In fact, it would turn out to be my last outing with her. I don't know, about 3-4 weeks before she died. She was so tired. But she was having so much fun. So Mom, I promise you this. I will play a few games for you every time I happen to go to the casino. But with a little bit of give from my side, I really hope that there'll be a little bit of take. So if you could show me in any way what is the winning machine, I'd like to take some money home with me. That would be great. Thanks, Mom. Mom, I hope you had a fantastic and a most amazing reunion with your mom, dad, siblings. I know that our time together on this earth has come to an end, but we will be reunited. But until then, we will miss you. Rest in peace. I love you. Thank you.
morning, everyone. I'm going to try and get through this. Mom, such a small word does not come close to describing what an amazing person you were. I know you never liked your name, Hermine. However, an ordinary name would never have suited such a unique and special woman as yourself. You have been many things to me, mom, confidant, advisor, mentor, teacher, cheerleader, supporter, and most of all, my very best friend. We have been through so much together, and I know that I was your rock and best friend as much as you were mine. You had a knack of always knowing when something was wrong with me and worrying me, and it wouldn't take you long to get it out of me. Not many girls get to have the privilege of having such a close and special relationship with their mothers, but I did. I'm so grateful and blessed to have had you in my life. Thank you, Lord, for making her my mom. You have been my role model, showing me daily the kind of relationship I continually strive for with my children. Thank you for all the sacrifices that you made to give us a home that was always warm, welcoming, and loving, not only to us, your children, but to any visitor that walked in the front door. Your generosity, giving heart, and willingness to help others is something that I will always remember. I want to take a moment to thank you, Andy, for not only loving and marrying me, but for loving and accepting and considering my mom as your own mom. You often hear people joke and say, when you marry the girl, you marry the girl's whole family. Well, that certainly was the case with us, especially having mom live with us with most of our married life. It is rare for a son-in-law to be so open to having his mother-in-law living with them, but a very special bond existed between you, and I will always be very thankful for that. Your love and support for mom and me over the past 4 years has been a tremendous blessing to us both. Thank you for always being available to take mom to doctor visits, chemo, and radiation sessions. I know that she did not take your involvement in her life for granted. Mom loved you as much as she loved her sons. If you were lucky enough to creep into her heart, there was nothing she wouldn't do for you. Mom was often our reality check. If we were thinking of doing something big, we would run it past her for advice and be sure that even if it wasn't what we wanted to hear, she would give her honest opinion. Thank you for being there for us, Mom. Your relationship with Darren, Matthew, and Kirsten has been a blessing and a special honor that I know they will cherish as they get older and start families of their own. You have taught us many things over the years, but I think the most important thing that you have taught us is to be brave, never give up, and fight for what you want. Thank you, Derry, Matt, and Kirsten, for all your help in looking after Nanny. I know that she appreciated everything that you did and knew that it wasn't easy to do and to see. Mom, your illness took so much from you, but the biggest thing it tried to steal was your independence. You fought for that till the last of your life. Even telling the nurse off, asking her, who is paying your bill? And you will decide if you want to be turned or not. Feisty and determined, you were not giving up without a say in it. It was an honor to look after you and care for you, and I would do it again in a heartbeat. I'm so grateful that I have so many wonderful memories that I can look back on. Mom loved playing board games, and Darren, Kirsten, Matthew, Aiden, Mom and myself, we'd often play some board games on a Friday or Saturday night, like 30 seconds or Time's Up. And we'd be laughing so hard that it would be a toss-up whether Aiden, Kirsten, or myself would be the first to pass out from lack of breath. Mom made a mean lion. She would enthusiastically move her body, but it wouldn't always coincide with what the actual word was that she was trying to describe. Mom loved watching movies, and we would often sit together and watch TV or whatever movie just happened to be on. I miss you so much that it hurts. I took it for granted that you would be here forever and that I could, talk to you whenever I wanted to. I can't believe that I have to say goodbye for now, but I know that God has called you home and that you're one of the angels watching over us. Thank you, Mama, for everything that you have done for me, but mostly just for loving and accepting me for me. Till I can hug and kiss you again and see your beautiful face, know that I love you more than you will ever know, Ellie.
Troy, there never was a reign of cuteness. You were never the cutest I was. I find it very difficult to talk about my mom. So I'm not going to. I'm going to read some messages that were sent, and I'm going to say some thank yous, because I want to try and hold it together. First message is from Mark and Gloria. Dear Dion, Charmaine and family, Sean, Maureen and family, Troy, Desiree and family, Alison, Andred and family, my mom, Gwen, Hermine's sister, her last remaining sibling and family. It is with great sadness that we have had to say goodbye to Hermine. Cancer took away from us long before she was ready to go. She, like many others, have succumbed to this terrible disease. Hermine was my mom's younger sister. Her family was everything to her. Her parents, siblings, and husband, and later her children, their spouses, and grandchildren were her life. She truly loved with all her heart. Hermine was one of the most sincerest people I knew. She was the epitome of love and generosity and goodness. She liked good things and yet was totally unmaterialistic. She would shower one with gifts as a token of her love to her family. If I could sum up Hermine's life in two words, it would be unconditional love. I was born when she was 13 years old, and my parents, brothers and sister, and I have always held her in great esteem throughout our entire lives. Hermine was, in many ways, more like an older sister to me than an aunt. When I was tiny, both she and Ian were my role models. I adored them. They were always together. I remember being 5 years old and Hermine squeezing me so tightly when she said goodbye to me that I started crying. She hurt me. That was the intensity of her love. Her love was so sincere that once in, she loved you for life. When I was tiny, I remember playing her records. Personality by Lloyd Price and The Witch Doctor by David Seville were my favorites. I believe that I was one of the few privileged to be allowed to do that. Hermione married Ian, and together they had 4 children. During their married life, I babysat their children from young so often that they were like an extension of my own family. I remember you all being brought up and being told to play together because you were brothers and sister. Please do not ever forget that. It is what your mom always wanted, and make a point to always stay in touch with each other. She went through some trying times in her life. She adored her children, their spouses and grandchildren, and loved them all with the same great passion as she loved and hurt me when I was little. I cannot let this opportunity go past without a special thank you to Alison and Andred. You two, your family, were so amazing to your mom. You will be totally blessed for your dedication and love that you showered her with daily, hourly, and minute by minute. I was always so extremely grateful how she accepted my wife Gloria and my children and treated us all so well. She was a blessing to so many. Gloria and I were so blessed to have seen her when we were in Cape Town a few months ago. We both knew that she did not have a long time with us. We spoke about many things then and telephonically often. I knew that she was a devoted Christian and that she was looking forward to seeing her mom and heavenly family again. But she was devastated to say goodbye to her family on earth, especially her children and Alison. Hermie, till we meet again. Much love, and may you spend your heavenly life with the angels and help to look after us all. May the Lord keep you in the palm of his hand. Mark and Gloria. Then there's a message from Andrew. Granny Hermie was such an inspiration to me. The strength she displayed, even at the toughest of times, was amazing. I always loved her sense of humor, which never faltered. When she smiled, you couldn't help but smile with her. One of my treasured memories of her was when she introduced me to the world of Indiana Jones by having me watch the second film with her, creating my love for adventure films. Watching her suffer from far away has been one of the toughest things I've ever had to do, but I can give thanks to God knowing that she is home with him and her pain and suffering is over. She's spending eternity with him, and it's not really goodbye. It breaks my heart now more than ever to be so far away, but all my love, thoughts, and prayers are with everyone. So, Gran, though you are not physically with us anymore, we treasure all the memories you leave with us, and I still get inspired by your strength every time I think of you. I'm so proud to be your grandson, and I will miss you dearly. I love you forever. Where's Karen's one? Ah, there we go. Before I read Karen's one, from my son Dylan, I'm so sorry I could not be here today due to work commitments. I know that I wish to be there more than anything. Granny Hermie, I love you. Thank you for being the strong and powerful woman you were, always seeking what's best for your grandchildren. I'll never forget all the moments we shared and the places you took us to when I was a little kid. I was so grateful to have known you, Granny Hermie. My heart pains today knowing that when I return to Cape Town, I won't be able to come and visit you as I normally do. Things might not be the same, but you will be forever in my heart, our heart. I love you, Granny Hermie. You will never be forgotten. Dad, Auntie Alison, Uncle Troy, Uncle Sean, I love you all. Be strong. I hope to see you soon. My prayers go out to you and the rest of the family. And then a message from Danny Magliolo in Port Elizabeth. I send my love to Dion, Sean, Troy, and Alison and your families. I cannot believe your mother is gone. My heart is broken. I will miss her terribly and know you are in my thoughts, Auntie Danny. And then a message from Karen. I did tell her to write this on waterproof paper. I cannot believe that the time has come to say goodbye to one of the most beautiful people I've ever had the pleasure of knowing and loving. It is so incredibly hard, but slightly bittersweet, too, because you shall find all comfort in her being at peace at last. It was such an excruciatingly long battle for Auntie Hermie, and battle she certainly did, right to the very end, with every ounce of her being. It is a true testament to her character and strength. Her name, Hermine, is derived from the German name Hermann, which means soldier, and that is oh so fitting. From the moment I met Auntie Hermie, she made me feel so welcome and comfortable. It was a huge family reunion 30 years ago, and there were so many people there that it was incredibly overwhelming. But when Stephen and I walked in, she straight away took me under her wing and ensured I felt part of the family as only she could do. I was so grateful. We spent a lot of time at the Goldie home in those days, and I loved going there and spending time with Auntie Hermie and the rest of the family, especially after Daniel was born. If he was ever niggly, then Stephen would say, "Why didn't you go and visit Auntie Hermie?" Because Daniel loved to jawl. The moment we got to Pinelands, he was one happy baby because he was spoiled rotten with cuddles and love from his great auntie. It was a very special time, and I will cherish that time spent with her forever. She was so caring and loving right till the end. When I was in hospital recently, even though she was incredibly ill, she would message me on a daily basis asking how I was feeling and letting me know that she was thinking of me and willing me to get better. In my eyes, Auntie Hermie was and always will be a superhero. To Auntie Hermie, thank you for being the beautiful, selfless, and loving lady that you always were. You always have and always will be an inspiration to me. I love you for all eternity. Karen, I'm gonna skip the... It's just too emotional. Part of my job is to say thanks as well. We're running out of time, so I'm going to be quick. Thanks go to the precept team for the continuous prayers, daily inquiry of the mom's health and love and support. Stuart and Teresa Kemsley, your prayers and concern. Stuart, for allowing Alison to work from home for the past 2 months, and trust me, that made a huge difference, enabling her to care for my mom to the end. Suzanne Brooks providing supper for the family, Sister Dalian from Creative Wellness Center, who was just a phone call away and came when she was needed. Robin, the nurse from Creative Wellness, who looked after mom so well in her last week and always treated her with respect. Karen, the social worker who organized the Creative Wellness Center on mom's behalf, who was always willing to listen. Paolo, Cape Medical Plan, who assisted mom with all her medical refunds and authorizations for the medication, and trust me, there were some fights there. To the paramedics, police, and Tigerberg funeral directors, thank you for making an extremely difficult night bearable with your compassion, efficiency, and respect. Peter Bradley, love, support, and many practical ways that you assisted her. Auntie Gwen, thank you for phoning often, your love and support. Your friendship meant the world to my mom. She considered you more than just a sister. To Mark and his family, for phoning almost every day and their love and support. Ilana and Julian, providing lunches and suppers and being so wonderful in trying to be there and assist us. Stephen and Karen, there really is so much to thank you guys for, but most importantly, we want to thank you for your constant love, support, messages, phone calls, and advice. The many visits you made to cheer mom up and your willingness to help us by doing night shifts and nursing care. Karen, I know that mom really appreciated what you did to help by looking after her. Thank you for the numerous practical ways that you assisted her. It helped us so much knowing that you were only a phone call away, right up to the very end. Andy, Alison, Derry, Matt, and Kirsten. Andy, you were mom's fourth son. And I'm pleased to say she appreciated the fact that she missed out on childbirth. But you were her fourth son. And as that, you accepted her unreservedly into your home. And I know you loved her like a son. And for all the things you did for her over the years, thank you. Derry, Matt, and Kirsten, you had Nanny in your daily lives, your whole lives. You drew enormous pleasure from watching, she drew enormous pleasure from watching you grow up. Thank you for assisting your mom and dad in looking after Nanny. It was not always an easy or convenient, but when you needed to, you were there to help. And lastly, and most importantly, I would like to thank Alison on behalf of my brothers and myself. For the phenomenal job she did in looking after my mom. She went beyond and above what anyone could ever expect of anybody. She did what was needed, when it was needed, and almost always with a smile. It was no picnic, and I'm sure we all know a fraction of what she actually did for mom. She was mom's verbal punching bag when she was closest, as she was the closest and easiest target when mom's resolve was at its lowest. Alison, I will be forever grateful for having a sister like you and for what you did for mom. And thank you all for coming here today. And those of you who didn't get to see her often in that opening video, I was watching it and I noticed something that she looked like a bedonnered tunny sometimes in those photos, eh? There's one thing about her, she hated having a photo taken, absolutely hated it. So she didn't always have a smile on her face, but trust me, under that look on that face sometimes, it was a pool of love that was endless, bottomless, and that continues today, I know. So thank you all for being here today.
Some closing remarks here. Don't grieve for me now that I'm free. I followed the path that God laid for me. I took his hand when I heard his call. I turned my back and left it all. I could not stay another day to laugh, to love, to work, to play. Tasks left undone must stay that way. I found the peace at the end of the day. If my parting has left a void, then fill it with remembered joy, a friendship shared, a laugh, a kiss. Yes, these things too I will miss. Be not burdened with time's sorrow, for I wish you all the sunshine of tomorrow. It was beautiful, as long as it lasted, the journey of my life. I have no regrets whatsoever, save the pain that I'll leave behind. Those dear hearts who loved and cared, the strong arms that held me up when my own strength let me down. At every turn in my life, I came across those who stood by me, even when time raced me by. Farewell, my loved ones. I smile and bid you goodbye. Shed no tears, for I need them not. All I need is your smile. If you feel sad, do think of me, for that's what I would like, to live in the hearts of those who loved me, and this way, I'll never die. Can we stand for the final hymn?
How I love.
Let's pray together. Loving God and Heavenly Father, before whom all generations rise and pass away, we find that even in the face of death, our words can be those of thanksgiving. We are thankful for the one who shared her life with us, one whose life was lived with vigor, for the struggles of life and for the triumph of character over trial, of courage over difficulty, of faith over sorrow, we give thanks. God grant us such strength in the memory of Mom that we might be thankful for the gift of her life that is given to each of us. And in our hearts, may her loss be balanced by thanksgiving for the life that was shared with us. And as each of us face a tomorrow in a world that Mom is no longer part of, may we carry our love for her and her love for each of us in our hearts until we meet together again in your glorious kingdom. Amen. For inasmuch as it has pleased Almighty God in his great mercy to receive unto himself in heaven the soul of Hermine Goldie, we now entrust her to God's mercy and to his eternity. Family and friends, would you receive the blessing of the Lord? The Lord bless you and watch over you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look kindly on you and give you peace. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.